Got the wrong one. Did you guys miss us? We're here, episode 49, Understanding CBD. Hello, Max Sobel.
Hello, Stephen Wallman.
Gentle reminder to anyone, do not take anything said on this program as professional, medical, or legal advice, please.
Right. We're not doctors and lawyers. That's what they're for. I know our moms would have been proud if we were, but we're not.
Yeah, sorry, moms. We're not doctors and lawyers. But every Sunday, as consistent as Margaret Rome, we show up here for a live show and help you understand CBD.
Right. And that's the best part of being live at the studio is that we got to run into Margaret Rome today. I don't know if the people listening know, but she hasn't missed the show. She missed one show in 8 years.
Right. One show.
Let's give her a shout out. Margaret Rome in here and staying strong.
And she was concerned about today because of the weather. And we're in Baltimore. For those that aren't, we had some snow outside. It's supposed to be more. But Margaret, if you ever need a ride, we're here to pick you up.
That's right.
All right. But we can't take her home. She'd have to sit through our show.
Right.
Awesome. Well, the good thing about being live is you can call in. I know we have a lot of questions. Last week, we had a ton of callers. We already have some people on the line anticipating our guest today. But the number to call is 410-922-6680. You can call that line. And also, you can listen to the show not from your radio, right? If you got to move around, you can connect from your smartphone or iPad.
Smartphone?
Right? iPad or something.
You can go to understandingcbd.com, and there's a button there that you can click on the top that says listen live or listen to the show live. And you can do that. You can also, I hear you can ask an Alexa to connect you with our show, too.
Good. Well, that's the place to be, Understanding CBD.
That's right, and the place to be.
Right. So we're enjoying
COVID-free
the show today. Max, what's up with the song choice? Love it, man.
Yeah.
You got the wrong one.
So there's a big theme going on, right? And so aside from being the song that gets played in practically every Vietnam movie, you know, ever, and I love those Vietnam flicks. I know you probably do, too. The real meaning about the song is protesting elitism, right, against the, you know, and that's... I don't think I have to, you know, let anybody read between the lines, but there's big things going on right now and protesting elitism and sort of, you know, understanding that you have your own independence. You know, that's a CCR jam, Creedence Clearwater Revival, 1969. I think it's real applicable right now.
It's the age of Aquarius.
It's the age of Aquarius.
Which is
knowledge.
The age of individualism. It's very appropriate.
Yep, we're all learning. We have to be independent thinkers. That's a very important thing right now.
Fantastic, man. Beautiful. Well, for the show today, it's going to be great. In addition to taking your calls, we have a great show planned. We have Doc G in his corner. He's got some questions left over from this past week. Looking forward to hearing what he's got for us. We have a special guest with us we want to introduce you to now, Ajay Sharma. Sharma, as we call him, okay? Registered pharmacist as well as an MBA. So it's a unique combination of skills, and it's interesting the conversations he must have in his head about it. He owns and operates Little Acorn Pharmacy right here in Maryland. Folks, he's local. He's from the Eastern Shore of Maryland. Excited to talk to him. Sharma, was no able to get you on the phone today.
Thank you so much.
Can you hear us?
Yes, I can. Thank you so much.
What's up, Sharma? How are you?
I'm doing great. I'm enjoying the snowfall. My kids are outside. My son's about to go to work.
Very nice.
He's gonna be making some subs today.
Very nice. Feeding hungry people. That's what we're all about here, too.
Yeah, we were just out on the roads, and in Maryland, they're pretty good. They're just as most of them have been treated. I think tomorrow may be the big concern, but, you know, we haven't had, they said, in 5 years, a snowstorm of this potential.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we need it.
Well, awesome. Welcome to the show, and we're looking forward to talking with you, getting to know you. You know, especially being from Maryland, you know, tell us what it's like growing up on the Eastern Shore.
I really loved growing up on the Eastern Shore. We did a lot of fishing, bicycle riding, motocross. It was just a wonderful place to grow up. I kind of wish my kids grew up there, too, but I had to move to the big city to go to school. I went to University of Maryland for pharmacy school. But I went to UMBC undergrad, and that was a great school, too.
Nice. What made you want to move away from the Eastern Shore? You know, some people may choose to stay fishing, right? I don't know, any of your friends stay around, or did everyone?
Yeah, well, I think there was opportunities at UMBC. I got a scholarship to go there, and my older brother was there. So, you know, I wanted to go to school and be with him, too. And we both really enjoyed University of Maryland.
Oh, nice.
Really nice school.
What did your brother go? Did he go down the same route? Did you guys study the same things? Or?
No, he studied computer science and information systems, and they have a great school for that. So now he's out west working with a company called Intuit. They do make TurboTax software.
Yeah, QuickBooks and such, yep.
Yeah, huge really, company.
I think a lot of people from Maryland schools do really well because they got a great education here.
It's all that good growing up on the Eastern Shore, right? It's all that good food and playing with outdoors, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, the things he was doing, it was playing with nature, right? You were connected with nature. You were.
Seems more people are trying to get back to nature now and trying to get back to the Eastern Shore, I would think.
I think so. It's a great place to retire, and my parents are there. They don't want to leave that area because, you know, my parents have been there since 1972.
Wow. Which part of Maryland?
They're in Salisbury.
I remember driving through there going to Ocean City. I love it.
Yeah, it's a great place. It's really nice. They got a great hospital. Cost of living is much lower than here, and it's a great place to live.
Sharma, I was reading up about a little bit of your bio when we were starting to get to know you. I hear you're also a musician.
Yeah, I play the drums. I originally went to school in engineering and music and then ended up in pharmacy. I don't know how that happened, but it just did. I still play the drums now, and I really enjoy it.
How'd we do on our song choice?
Oh, it's one of my favorites.
Nice.
I was singing along with it.
My man. Let me ask you a question. So let's get the music buff question out. Are you a Beatles guy or are you a Stones guy?
I would say both.
Really?
I've seen the Stones live a couple times. They're great. You're singing along the whole concert. I saw them in two different decades. And, you know, Mick is running up and down the stage, no matter how old he is.
Mm-hmm.
He's a wonderful a singer, a musician, and I understand that he does triathlons and used to do triathlons and stuff. He's really in great shape.
Yeah, that's one advantage the Stones have is they can perform live today, you know?
Yep. Right. Whatever's keeping them going, perfect.
Yeah, that's awesome. How about drummers? Do you have a favorite drummer or someone that inspired you? I know I used to be a drummer, I mean, back when I was in, I think, sixth or seventh grade. And I had a drummer that was in our same grade, John Lampkin, and he was amazing. Uh-huh. He was so amazing, he made me quit drumming.
Made you question your choices?
I was like, I'm not gifted like this guy.
Right.
But who did you look up to, Sharma? Any drummers that you...
Growing up, Neil Peart was a great drummer I used to listen to. I listened to just as many jazz drummers, too. So, like, I would listen to old vinyl, like Max Roach and a lot of jazz drummers. They are a different style. But, I mean, you need a lot of different styles to put in your vocabulary when you're playing the drums. Because something you might have picked up, jazz drumming, might fit into a rock and roll phrase you're playing. Or if you're playing with the blues musician, you might be able to use a phrase that you learned a long time ago playing jazz or heard one of the jazz greats playing, and it just fits right in.
I could see the correlation. I mean, you have to be you have to have a good rhythm and you have to be meticulous in what you do, so I can see the correlation of how you took your love for music into what you do professionally, right?
Oh yeah, it's what I do professionally is a lot like cooking.
Mm-hmm.
I make compounds for people. The doctor pretty much says what they want in the compound, and we formulate the compound so it gets absorbed in your skin or, you know, through your in your mouth or swallowed like a capsule. So we make things that are not available on the market, and we make them so that we can give them to you so you get the correct dose like the doctor wanted you to.
That's important.
Yeah, a lot of people don't understand what exactly a compounding pharmacy does and what makes that different is unique. And what scenarios come up that someone would need or could use a compounding pharmacy?
Most commonly, I would say it's an oral dose for a child. Saying your child needs a dose of medication and it only comes in, say, 100 milligram tablets, but the doctor says, oh, man, if I give your child a 100 milligram tablet, you know, that's going to be too high of a dose. So what are we going to do? he'll call a compounding pharmacy, and the compounder will either get that chemical and provide it, like, say, 5 milligrams and put it in a liquid so they can take it by mouth. And we flavor it so that a child would like it. So it's not just about the chemical itself. You have to make it what's known as pharmaceutically elegant.
Pharmaceutically elegant.
I'm going to write that
that's
down.
That's a word that old compounders use to say, hey, the cream looked great. The production was great. How you gave it to the customer was great. That's a pharmaceutically elegant product.
Wow.
And that is very, very important in pharmacy.
Now, that's a good topic, and to translate it into, in my world back in the day, instead of, it would, you know, in the software world, is a complete product or a whole product. It wasn't just the specific code base. It was the way it was delivered, how it was delivered, the intention of everything.
Right, right. I agree. Yeah. That's a good
and I
analogy.
Think nowadays, you might find that in, I think the people that do it the best are probably like Apple, and people have learned from Apple, and innovators have learned from them to make something so easy to use that anyone can use it.
That's right.
That's a beautiful way to go out. We need to take a break, Sharma. Stay with us, everyone. Come back with some more questions. We got a lot of calls for you. Take a break. See you soon.
Thank you. See you soon, Sharma.
Welcome in, everybody, back into Understanding CBD. We have Max Sobel here. I'm Stephen Wallman. We have AJ Sharma with us on the line. AJ, you still with us?
Yes, sir.
All right. He made it through the break. Fantastic. Everyone can make it here. We have a couple callers on the line already we wanted to get to. But please don't hesitate to give us a call because we will have time for a few more.
The number is 410-922-6680. Call us. Sorry, buddy. Go.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Sharma, I wanted to ask you real quick before we get to the callers. And sort of something that's been on my mind about potency and absorption. It was one of the details when we were formulating our product to decide, you know, what concentration do we want it. And I understand that the potency does impact how well or not well or how effective a product is, regardless of what it is. Can you talk to that for a minute and sort of explain how potency does impact the potential interaction and how the body uses it?
Well, there are many different products out there. And you can have a product that has a strong concentration. Now, the problem is some products have a concentration they say that is high, but it's not tested. So they can say, like, the concentration is 10 milligrams per half an ml. If you have a concentration of 10 milligrams per half an ml and it's not tested as such, then your body is actually getting much less of a concentration. The delivery and what it is delivered in is also very important. Oil, generally in CBD, is much more helpful in delivering than a water-based product because it goes through the epithelial cells and underneath the tongue. So in that respect, when you have a oil-based product, it works much better than a water-based product.
That's a good point. And that was sort of what I was really interested in because we got a lot of questions about us offering different products. And we've chosen our specific oil extract for the ability for it to absorb underneath the tongue, which is a good way of absorbing, versus ingesting it and being on your skin. A lot of people would ask us, will I fail a drug test if I use your product? And we've always said, well, if you put it on your skin, even if it has high THC, it won't absorb into your bloodstream. But if you ingest it, if you put it under your tongue or eat it, it could get into your bloodstream for a test. Mm-hmm. I think that's really how it comes up, right, Max?
That's how it comes up, yep.
Well, that's true. It does get in your bloodstream.
Now, does it not get in your bloodstream through a cream, like when you put it topically?
It all depends on what the device is, what kind of cream it is. When we compound, we have creams that go just on the very outer parts of your skin, and then some that go all the way through your skin, so that it goes into your blood.
Oh, interesting.
It's absorbed much better that way, and that would be like, suppose if we're giving an estrogen or a testosterone, we want that to go through the skin.
Okay.
But if you or a pain medicine, we want that to go through the skin. But if you're treating the skin, like say for a rash, you don't want the medicine to go through the skin. You want it to treat the skin itself. So you don't want a product that's going to go all the way through the skin in that case.
Fascinating. Okay. So it's one of those things where a lot of times we want an easy answer to complex questions.
Nothing's easy.
You know what I mean? I do want to get to a caller. We have Vicky on the phone.
Oh, right? All right. That's my wife. So Sharma, she's been bugging me all week because she knew that you were coming on the show. So you have I don't want to call it small. You know, I don't mean to put it down, but you have a family-owned mom-and-pop type of a pharmacy, right?
That's right.
Right. So the natural question that we always have, and I'm sure a lot of people have, is, you know, why would you go to a small pharmacy like that versus going to the big Walgreens and such? And my wife is on the phone because she actually worked for a small pharmacy when she was a teenager.
So you just told him why? You just told her the question?
Well, no. She hasn't asked the question yet. Okay. She works for a small pharmacy, and she wants to ask you a question.
That's great.
Hi.
Nice to hear. Hi. How are you?
Can you guys hear me?
We can hear you.
Hey, this is Vicky. Hi, Max. Hi, Steven.
Hi, Mrs. Mailsack.
So nice to meet you, Mr. Sharma. Thank you. Thank you for being on the show today. And I just wanted to call in to say hi and tell everybody that it's so beautiful outside. And Max and Steven went out in the snow to bring this wonderful show to everybody. So, but my question is, I just wanted to say that I relate to Sharma, can I call you Sharma, Mr. Sharma?
Yeah, you can call Sharma. Me Sharma, you can call me AJ.
Like Max said, when I was a teenager, I worked at a local pharmacy. Shout out to Charles Mead Pharmacy in Ruxton, Maryland. and there, it was like a local pharmacy, mom and pop, owned by a gentleman named Bernie. And Bernie was like the celebrity in the town because back then, everybody would come to the pharmacy and they would go to the lunch counter, which is where I worked, and get their soda pop and their milkshakes, and then they would go and talk to the pharmacist. And they would talk to him about all sorts of things related to their ailments and medication, but they also trusted him so much that they would, you know, chat with him about everything under the sun. So my question is, you know, now in this day and age with like Rite Aid and Walgreens and all these, you know, the big retailers, you know, they have a consultation window, but every time I go there, nobody's actually there. Nobody goes there to consult. But with this, you know, mom and pop local pharmacy, the customers would go and, you know, talk to their pharmacist. So I'm just curious, do your customers and patients, I don't know what you call them, but customers, I guess, do they come in and are they looking for alternative methods to treat some of their ailments, such as, you know, use of CBD? And, you know, does CBD come up, and what kind of questions do they ask? What are they curious about? And also, how do you advise them?
Great.
So, well, yeah, we, in small pharmacies, we get to know people a lot better. I have some of my best friends are actually, they started out as my customers. I worked in other pharmacies, like for the big chains for many years, and I saved up money and then opened up my own store 5 years ago, and I'm not looking back. The big stores, one thing for sure, is a battle of attrition. They hire a lot of pharmacists and they go through a lot of pharmacists because they do so many prescriptions that those poor pharmacists has no time to talk to their customers and get to know them. And they're just really worried about making sure someone doesn't get the wrong medication because they're, you know, checking hundreds and hundreds of prescriptions. So that's a big deal for pharmacy presently. I get lots of questions about what should I take as far as nutritionals and as far as weight loss and about CBD. CBD, I think I wish had come around about 25 years ago, because a lot of the people that have arthritis now and then in their 60s and 70s didn't have a chance to take it in their 50s and 60s because CBD wasn't around. And now it is, and we know that it really helps for inflammation. So inflammation is not a simple thing. There's many different parts to it. And CBD has been effective for inflammation. I wish that it had been around for 25 years, maybe when Max and Steven were just teenagers. they could have made their CBD oil back then.
Amen. But
the thing bends the CBD by now.
Just want to remind the audience, if you're just joining us, we're talking to Ajay Sharma. He's a pharmacist and a fantastic guy. And we just got through some questions. And do we have anybody else queued up? Thank you, Vicky Sobel, for the wonderful question.
Yeah, thanks, Vicky. Yeah, Max and I were busy with THC 25 years ago.
That's right.
And didn't have aches and pains at that time of the physical nature, so we were treating other issues.
That's right.
Anyway, we do have another caller. Speaking of my childhood, my mom's on the phone.
Yeah, it's a family affair today. I love it.
Hey, Sharma. And we have my mother, Janet. Janet Walman, hello.
Hello.
Hi, Miss Janet. How are you?
I am fine. How are you?
I'm doing great. I'm so happy to be on here with your son.
Yeah, I'm happy to hear. I listen to his show every week. He and Max do a great job.
Thank you.
And I had a question for you about a interaction of a medication that I take every day.
Sure.
I had breast cancer 5 years ago, and so I'm still on letrozole. And sure. I wanted to know if there's any drug interaction with that and the CBD that I take every day.
So CBD is metabolized. That means when it goes into your system, the body gets rid of it, per se, through your liver.
Okay.
So there's certain enzymes that function in your liver to do that. And what I'd have to know first is letrozole, what enzymes actually metabolize it. That means what enzymes take care of it so that it can get rid of it out of your body.
Okay.
And then find out. So CBD does have interaction. I would have to actually look up the letrozole, and I can get back to you and find out exactly what happened. And this is
okay, because I wasn't sure. I didn't think there was an interaction with it, but I really always had that question and didn't know whether...
Well, that's a good question.
For me.
And yeah, well, the other side of the question, which would be, what enzyme does CBD interact with, and maybe that could also be another. Because what I've heard and what Max and I tell people is, if your drugs say that they interact with grapefruit, that's a similar enzyme.
Right. That's exactly right, because that has similar effects in the liver.
I take Lipitor for cholesterol, and I was told to take that, you know, don't take it together with the CBD. So I take that in the morning, and then I use the CBD at night before I go to bed.
So actually, the cholesterol medicine should be taken in the evening. And I would just say, as long as you're taking both of them simultaneously, ask the doctor to check your levels, because your levels... Actually, you won't need as much of the Lipitor, the atorvastatin,
uh-huh.
as you did previously to taking CBD, because the CBD actually slows the Lipitor's metabolism.
Oh.
So it leaves your body a little bit slower if you're taking CBD. Now, if you take CBD just every once in a while,
no, I take it usually every night before I go to bed.
As do I.
Okay.
It's really effective for me.
Sharma, we've always told people that if they are on any kind of the medication like that, to take the CBD either 2 hours before or after. Is that sort of in line with what you say?
That is, except for drugs that you would take in the evening.
Okay.
Like, suppose the cholesterol medicines work better because your body makes cholesterol at night. So they want you to take cholesterol medicine in the evening time. So when you take cholesterol medicine and then you take the CBD, it won't make, the two-hour window won't make a difference.
Okay, I see.
That drug has a long half-life. It'll last in your system for about 24 hours.
You know, it's interesting. I've been taking the Lipitor for 10 years and was never told that I need to take it at night. So that's something that...
Yeah, well, that's good. Well, listen, Sharma, we have about 30 seconds left, and before we go to break again and come back with Doc G's Corner, I want to make sure people know how to get in touch with you and where Little Acorn Pharmacy is so they can continue the conversation with you as needed, because, you know, you really provide some sound advice here, and I think a lot of people could benefit from it.
Sure. Yes, we are in Silver Spring. I've been there for 5 years. We have a drive-through right now, which is very important during COVID. I haven't opened the front end of the store up. So we're at the next traffic light away from the FDA, the Food and Drug Administration. It's 11161 New Hampshire Avenue. And actually, there's a lot of people from the FDA that come and shop there. And they're always giving us information, and we give them information. And occasionally, I take a few of them on to be students to learn how to compound.
That's great. And a phone number for you?
It's 301-592-0060.
Thank you, Sharma. We appreciate you. And we'll be right back.
Thank you, Sharma.
Doc G's Corner.
It was great having you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And I really enjoyed using your product.
Thank you. Talk to you soon.
I'm glad you guys are in Maryland.
We're glad you are, too.
Good to see you, Doc G. How are you today?
Oh, another day in paradise.
You like this weather? You like the snow, or what do you think?
I like looking at it. I like visiting it. I'm not so sure about living in it. But
yeah, with the Arizona t-shirt on, I'd imagine you'd probably prefer that weather today than what they're having here.
Me too.
Hey, wasn't Ajay Sharma great? I utilize his pharmacy, and very high quality. I trust their compounding.
Good. Good to know. We appreciate it.
So thank you guys for having me. It was great listening to Sharma and to you guys interviewing him. I am Dr. Ben Gonzalez, and this is Dr. G's Corner. I've had quite a few questions in my emails and DM'd on IG and in Facebook since last week's interview. And many of these questions are common questions I get asked all the time. So I thought it's answering most of those, the common ones here would help many of the listeners. So let's get right to it. So question number one is the most common question I get is CBD legal? This is an important question, has a complicated answer. The answer is, it depends. CBD suddenly is everywhere, gas station, grocery stores, gyms, at your veterinarian's office, hotel spots, for gosh sakes, you know, everywhere. If you go to the FDA website, what you will find is confusion. Legality depends on state-to-state regulations. The strange fact exists that though in some states it's illegal to sell CBD, it is legal to purchase CBD. The 2018 Farm Bill legalized hemp cultivation and removed some of the cannabis, or some cannabis from Schedule I status by creating a legal distinction between hemp and marijuana. Under the new legislation, hemp is classified as cannabis that contains less than 0.3% THC by weight, while marijuana is classified as cannabis that contains more than 0.3%. Because marijuana is categorized as a Schedule I substance, CBD that is derived from marijuana plant is still considered federally illegal. While hemp is now considered an agricultural commodity, it still must be produced and sold under the regulations that the CBD that the 2018 Farm Bill refers to. The USDA has yet to create these regulations. The nation's first college course on this subject began at the University of Connecticut in 2019. Even with the research and legal power behind the course, they are confused and continue to sort out, it's just all confusing, to sort out all the rules, policies, and laws surrounding CBD. Again, The FDA's own website is not clear. Many employers are stuck in old policies that do not distinguish CBD from THC, the hallucinogenic ingredient in marijuana. Unfortunately, you must follow the policies of your employer and sort out the state laws concerning the use of CBD. A second most popular question is, does CBD interact with medications? There was a question, I think, to Ajay Sharma about that. Research has shown CBD is very safe to use in general. However, there are some considerations. Not to get too geeky here, but there is a family of enzymes, and this is referred to in that question earlier, especially in the liver, called the cytochrome P450 system that processes foreign substances in the body. And medications are foreign substances, right? It is that cytochrome P450 system that metabolizes CBD. This can change how other medications are processed in the body. This doesn't mean you can't take CBD, but it does mean you need to change the dosing of CBD or the medication that must be coordinated with your physician. There's a rule of thumb I tell my patients, and again, it was referred to in that question for Sharma earlier. There are certain medications that have a grapefruit warning on the label. This indicates that grapefruit and certain citrus fruits inhibit the cytochrome P450 system. If you see a grapefruit warning on your medication, I tell my patients to avoid CBD momentarily until you speak with your physician so they can coordinate the use of CBD. And statins are a good example of that. Another interesting and popular question popped up this week. And it was, can I get addicted to CBD? A properly tested CBD oil with an accompanying certificate of analysis that shows a THC less than 0.3% is safe and does not have addictive properties. A March 2017 study published in the Journal of Drug and Alcohol Dependence reviewed details of previous studies where researchers administered various oral doses of CBD to frequent marijuana users alone and in combination with smoked marijuana. The researchers determined that CBD had as much likelihood for abuse and addiction as a placebo. In other words, no addictive properties at all. And a 2011 study concluded that CBD has a better safety profile compared to THC, and researchers found that high doses of CBD of up to 1,500 milligrams per day were well tolerated by human subjects. Just to give you perspective, that would be three entire bottles of the Max and Steven CBD oil used per day, deemed safe and well tolerated. Compared to THC, CBD did not impair motor and psychological functions, nor did it alter the heart rate, blood pressure, or body temperature. So to be clear, depending on what I am treating, my recommendation average is around 60 to 120 milligrams a day, which is the most I recommend. The most I recommend is up to 500 milligrams a day, which is very rare for certain instances.
Yeah, clearly we need more time for more answers to many questions. They're not just simple answers, so we got to go into it. Thank
Doc
you.
G's got to come back for a
Thank you,
segment.
Doc G. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Signed, sealed, delivered. This is the section we like to talk about our favorite sponsor of Understanding CBD.
Who's that sponsor, Steven?
That's Max and Steven's Premium Hemp Extracts. We love them. They love us.
And what they say is in the bottle.
Is in the bottle.
My man.
That's right. So we got a couple stories for you guys. You know, we get questions daily. From customers, not customers, people all in our lives, strangers even, that ask us questions all the time. But we also get a lot of referrals, and we have our friend Honey. She's actually been on the show before. I think she gave us a comment on answering some of the questions that people have, the difference between THC and marijuana. I'll have
right.
to look up the episode. But she also talks a lot. She works at one of the dispensaries. And when people need that don't need THC and need looking for CBD, she sends them over to us. And Max, you talked to one of her referrals last week, right?
Yeah, I did. It was a referral from Honey, so Honey, thank you for that. And this was a woman that was dealing with chronic pain, and she had tried some typical CBD creams, or she calls typical CBD creams. I think she mentioned that she picked some up. I think it was Wegmans or Walgreens or one of those, you know, large chains.
W stores.
Yeah. And, you know, a couple of things she didn't know. First of all, she didn't know that she didn't have to use a cream. She didn't know that she could take an oil sublingually, but she also didn't know that she could use that oil topically. So that was enlightening for her, gave her that information. And, you know, she tried it, but she's going to try a bottle. Probably by now she's actually tried it. So thank you for that. Anytime you have a question, you can call us. Our number, by the way, 443-743-2444. That's the number for our company, Max and Stevens Premium Hemp Extracts. And we really recommend you call us and ask us your questions. You can also text us.
Yeah, that's good. You can text that or email hello@understandingcbd.com.
Right.
Hello@maxandstevens.com. We get all that. There's also action on the Facebook group.
There's action on the Facebook group.
I hear.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I mean, you know, I like Facebook. But, you know, you know, I'd like there to be more engagement on the group. I'm not sure if people like it anymore. It's so, I don't know.
I don't know if anybody's using Facebook anymore.
I don't know.
Maybe.
I don't know. If you are, listen, if no one mentions anything on the Facebook group, then I guess we get our answer.
Yeah. You know what I do know? I do know that people are listening to this show because we also got a call from a WCBM listener. And this was pretty cool because those come up. And, you know, these are people traditionally that listen to our show. And they want to call us and ask us a question. Maybe they don't want to call during the time of the show. Maybe they write down the phone number when they get to us later. Mm-hmm. But this was a woman that I spoke to also that she really appreciated our honesty. She said that she enjoyed our show. True story. I'm not making it up. She was complaining about some arthritis issues in her hands. And she wanted to, you know how to take it, you know, why should I trust you, that kind of thing. I do like you guys on the radio, again, just to throw that plug in. She did give us props. We appreciate it.
And she liked the radio show, but she was still asking questions about the product,
well,
right?
I think she liked the radio show enough to be able to reach out and feel comfortable enough to ask us a question. And she even, you know, after talking, she even is getting an extra bottle for her son to try. So I told her to keep in touch. And here's the other thing is she doesn't like using the internet. She doesn't have an email address. You know, she preferred
it's
just
so
being
common for us to help customers like that.
She just preferred to call in the order and have it done that way. So thank you very much for that.
Yeah, and maybe people don't know that. The number we give you, 443-743-2444. You can call that, and we can process your order, ship it. You don't have to deal with email or anything like that.
You'll talk to either Steven or myself every single time. Nobody else answers our phones.
That's important to us.
Very important to us.
We'd like to thank our guests today. Ajay Sharma, Little Acorn Pharmacy in Silver Spring. What a great guest. And again, it's like we have such limited time on the show. There's so many more questions we could still get to go throughout. So thank you. Doc G, we appreciate you as always coming for Doc G's Corner. I mean, those top questions that he answered today, it's really just, again, there's so many more.
Thank you for the callers that called in. Thank you, Vicky. Thank you, Janet. And we want to also thank our sponsors. That's us, Max and Stevens Premium Hemp Extracts. You can find us at www.maxandstevens.com, or you can call us 443-743-2444. You can also text us. All of these episodes are on understandingcbd.com. God bless you. Have a great week, and we'll see you episode number 50.
And next week. Right. We got on the next week. Do you know who's coming next week? You guys got to listen.